An injustice anywhere is an injustice everywhere. And we, being members of the East African community, I think it is time to call upon every human rights defender to come out clear and against this oppression that is happening in Uganda. We cannot be an East African community that only celebrates trade, that only celebrates culture, that only celebrates other things. But when it comes to human rights violations, we keep silent and mum, and we're not saying anything. That's why we've come here together as human rights defenders to say that whatever is happening in Uganda must stop. That we are calling upon the release of Bobi Wine, because it is the reason as to why many people are being killed in Uganda. As we speak, over 20s and 30s are already killed because of the unrest in Uganda. And this is becoming a security issue. So we are even calling upon the international organizations, AU, and many others that have actually been silent. It is time to speak for Uganda now, or else we will not have Uganda in the future.
Ever since Chabulani was arrested on Wednesday, they didn't allow any of his lawyers, family members, even the medical team to see him. And we are worried about his condition because we can't trust one of our own in the hands of our enemy. I hear that today they have taken him to court, but they are bringing bogus rules that he violated. They are trying to say he violated COVID rules. If you have been following seven campaigns, he rallies people behind him when he's also going for his campaigns. So why not put a fair ground for all the candidates? Why is he tying upon the hands and legs of other candidates, yet for him he wants to be free? So we are calling upon the release of Bobi Wine and the freeing of all Ugandans. Many Ugandans have lost their lives. Our media in Uganda can't report that. That's why yesterday we also came up with a press conference, because we want people to know this.
The manner in which his arrest was executed involved force, resulting to violent protests in various parts of Uganda. We note with serious concern that there was excessive use of force in dispersing protesters, which led to civilian deaths, injuries, and disruption of people's ways of living due to heavy police and army deployment in the country. In light of the foregoing, we call upon the government of Uganda to conform to the principles of human rights and promote the same as enshrined in the Banjul Charter, to which Uganda ratified in 1986. We demand the release of Honorable Robert Kyagulanyi Ssentamu, aka Bobi Wine, on reasonable bail terms to avert more violent protests in the country. We also demand that the government of Uganda takes appropriate, reasonable, and peaceful measures to avoid a culmination of violence towards the general elections set to take place in January next year, that is 2021. This statement has been signed and endorsed by the following organizations: Haki Africa, Bunge Mashinani Initiative, Heal Africa Trust, Trust Africa, Peace and Security Institute of Africa, Kituo cha Haki, Magharibi Social Justice Center, Sisters for Justice, Institute for Land Governance and Human Rights, Defenders Coalition, Fair Action Network, and APADEC, that is Association d'Action du Pays et de Développement Communautaire. Thank you.